Hey everybody, today's commentary is going to be pretty gloomy, so I apologize for that. I would also like to thank WhosImmortal. He gave me some gameplay that I can use to show what these new reserve cases are all about. So big thank you to him for allowing me to use his gameplay. If you guys could do me a favor, check out his channel linked in the description below. Hit him up with a subscribe and let him know that Prestige sent you. Guys, I'm going to be honest with you. I have this like weird, I guess you could say, an uneasy feeling in the pit of my stomach. I feel like there's just a huge shadow over me. Like, we have this huge update, and it's, like, full of awesome stuff, and there's so many cool things to do, but I'm just overshadowed by the fact that supply drops are back in the game, and they changed my tier system, and I don't like it at all, the way that my tier system's been changed, and we'll talk about that. But let's start with these cases. So today, there was a new thing called reserve cases added to the game. A reserve case can be purchased for 200 COD points, and when you do that, you get 3 items in the case. The items can contain things that you may have missed from before. So for example, you can get weapon skins and items from previous operations that are now in this reserve system. You can get Mastercraft camos. You can get blackout characters. You can get all this stuff. All of these items can be found in regular reserves, which have now been moved to this new circular play in-game time type of thing. Okay, so like your reserves that you normally earn in the contraband stream, you will also have this case that will fill up with time. So there's two time mechanics now. We have our regular tiers and we have this box. And from what I understand, it's either right around the same amount of time, so like 55 minutes, or it's even more time to earn one of these. I've had people saying they've been playing like Team Deathmatch and it's taken upwards of 2 hours to earn one of these things. It's crazy to me. So you get one of these cases, right? And when you open it, you only get one item. So just like the tier system, when you got one item for getting one tier, when you get one reserve case, you get one item. And that item could be a duplicate. My plan was I was going to go ahead and use my COD points that I had to go to tier 100, and then I would start doing my tiers, right? Because it makes sense. You would get the cases, and then you would also get the tiers, right? But that's changed too. Once you get to the tiers, once you get past tier 100, you don't earn anything in the tiers. You can still rank it up all day long. You can go to tier 5,000, and you won't get anything. You get nothing. Nothing. You only get one item from the case. So you grind for 100 hours, you play the game for 100 hours, and then once you get to that final tier, and you're like, yeah, tier 101, here we come, now I'm going to start earning these cases, and I'm going to start earning these tiers. No. Fuck you. Why did they change that? I don't understand. And then here's another big middle finger, right? In the black market, in the system, right? You could go to the black market, and there's the Party Rock camo. Huge fan of that camo? Of course I'm going to pick it up. When you pick up that camo, you get a 5% increase to earning tiers. What the fuck am I going to use that for? I just bought all 100 tiers. If I would have known from the get-go that I wasn't going to get anything at all from the tier system after 100, I would have never done it. Ever. It just doesn't make any sense. I don't know who's calling the shots, man. Like, I'm completely flabbergasted. I really am. The fact that I'm more upset about something rather than being able to enjoy what's there is really mind-boggling to me. It really is. Like, okay, I gotta remember that I have to give constructive feedback. So here is my first piece of constructive feedback. If somebody is willing to play or spend $100 to get to tier 100, then the bonus to being at tier 100 should be you gain additional reserves. So alongside getting the reserve from your tier, you could also get the reserve from the case that you're earning by timing up that bar that goes in a big circle. Okay, that's my first piece of constructive feedback. I think that it's only fair if someone's going to spend a lot of time going through the game and playing through the game, you should reward them from the tier system and the case system. It makes sense to be that way. My second piece of criticism, get rid of the cases altogether. Just go back to the way it was before. When you got to tier 100, you start earning reserves that way. You could still keep your 200 COD point reserve case, whatever. You could keep that. I don't care about that. I'm just saying, it's weird to go to tier 101, 102, 103 and see a blank spot. It just doesn't make any sense. My third piece of constructive criticism. If it's not going to change, which I'm almost certain, I'm almost like 1,000%, I'm almost 1,000,000% certain that this is going to stay the way it is and it's not going to change at all, I would say make it to where you can earn those reserve cases faster. And if you get a bonus, like a tier system bonus, make that go towards the reserve case. That's really all I can say about that specific thing. The other thing that really bothers me about these reserve cases, and you're going to see it throughout this video, and you've probably already noticed it in Who's Immortal's video, you see a lot of the same camo. This is, once again, one of the most egregious things that they could have done, because that means you have a chance to get this camouflage, the same exact camo, for every single gun in the game. Yeah, you don't just earn the camo once, you have to earn it once for every single gun in the game. Do you know how much that pads out the system itself? I mean, there are people from previous operations that never even made it to tier 100. There are people from previous operations that will never see all of these camos. It should never be that way. That is horrible. That's absolutely horrible. It's horrifying, too. I mean, as someone who has put a lot of time into this game, I would not want to see the same camo pop up multiple times because you're getting it for different weapons. I mean, it's that camo times however many weapons are in the game, and who knows how many of those types of camos are in the system right now. It is egregious. It is horrible. It is horrifying. Like, I definitely understand that this gives the developers some breathing time to make more content and push less into the reserves. But that is just awful. That is absolutely abysmal. I feel like we were really in that sweet spot last operation. And I spent so much time. And I spent a lot of money, admittedly. I think it was like $150 in total on the tier system. And I was so happy to see that final thing. Hey, you unlocked everything in the tier system. I was so excited to see that you could get a tier boost because I was thinking in my mind, oh, now I don't have to spend as much money because I'm going to have a tier boost and I'm going to be playing the game anyway, so I'm going to earn things faster. All that stuff was thrown out the window. All of it. And yeah, I'm happy that I have all the items from the previous operation, but that doesn't talk about this operation, where there's more items than we've ever seen before, and more is going to be added every single week. Every single week. It's going to be harder to find those blackout characters because there's blackout characters in reserves now. We haven't seen that before. There's blackout characters. There's a zombie girl. There's a zombie boy. Vacation Hudson's in there. And then who knows how many other characters are going to come into the reserves. And that's another thing too. Like, we were told in the beginning of this game that there would be no characters locked behind a paywall. And I'm sorry. If you play the game like normal, you're not going to get the blackout characters. There's just no way. Your hand is literally forced into spending money. The only way you would be able to do this is if you literally made playing this game your full-time job. And even then, you still can't do it. Unless you spend money. I'm sorry. You just can't. You can't do it. The tier system needs to be sped up. If it's going to be that way, it needs to be sped up. Everything needs to be sped up. Earning stuff needs to be sped up. That's just it. I mean, it's already been sped up before. It needs to be sped up like by 5 times. It needs to go way faster than it is now. Especially with the amount of items that are in this game. I remember looking back, I remember people, like most of the devs, and I remember Vonderhaar, he was saying like, all the blackout characters, you're going to be able to earn them by playing the game and doing all these little missions in the game. So when they announced we're going to get like Ultimus Richtofen and Ultimus Takio, and then it was like, oh, nope, you have to buy it. Okay, I get that. You have to buy it. But then when you have characters that people have literally been asking for since the launch of this game, zombie characters, like actual zombies, to play as an actual zombie, you're going to put those in reserves? Give me a damn break, man. I mean, dude. How much money do you want us to spend? Like, this is a free-to-play game at this point. This is everything that you would see in a free-to-play game. And if the game was free-to-play, all of this would be getting a pass. I mean, look at what Fortnite... Look at what Apex Legends does. Apex Legends have $21 camos on their guns. And they get a little bit of shit, but guess what? Everyone defends it because guess what? It's free-to-play! Anyway, guys, I'm going to end this commentary here. My top suggestions... Give us our tears back alongside the cases. That's the first... Like, that's the one that I want so bad. I just want our tears back, man. That's all I want. Give me back my reserve tiers. Let us keep the cases. I don't give a shit if people want to spend their money. I don't care. Let it go that way too. And finally, speed everything up. Just speed it up, man. Like, damn, dude. I know that there's like requirements and like estimated times that you need people to play online to make it show good, average times and stuff like that, but speed things up. 100% they need to be sped up. Anyway, that's all I'm going to say. If you agree with what I had to say, leave a like on the video. If you disagree with what I had to say, then leave a dislike on the video and let me know down below in the comment section why you don't agree with me. I would really be interested in knowing your thought process on it. And of course, if anyone from Activision is watching this, like, just make a Reddit post and explain this. Like, explain what the point of this was. Make a Reddit post and talk about this. We need to know more. Anyway, guys. Subscribe for more. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.